tester.co.uk.
Hello YouTubers, and welcome to this tutorial on how to check whether a Zener diode is working, or in particular to check the value of a Zener diode. Now this can potentially be a little challenging because your standard multimeter doesn't have the enough voltage and potentially current to obviously check a Zener diode when it's reverse biased to see the Zener effect and therefore give you that value. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take you onto the bench. There's a potentially very simple method with a variable power supply. I'm going to show you with three variable power supplies as the functionality might change between power supplies, and we'll check how to see what the measured value of the Zener diode is when it's reverse biased.
Right then, so let's just go through the potential scenario you might face, like I came across. I have a little storage container with loads of packets of Zener diodes that I went and bought at an electronic shop. Now, the gent at the electronic shop went and kindly noted on the packets the actual value of the Zener diodes. But now, what happens if I happen to have taken a whole lot out and they've got mixed up and I'm not sure of the values? That's one scenario. You can obviously, the all diodes should have a number on them, so that's stating exactly what it is, so you can actually go and look up on a data sheet, but that number sometimes can be very small, and then you need to obviously get to a PC, onto the internet. So this might be one method which could be of help to you. Now, the other thing to note is that potentially you might be looking for a particular value of a Zener diode. And as I'm going to demonstrate, even though a manufacturer might claim a Zener diode works at a particular voltage, there obviously is some tolerance on that. And through this process, you can go and see exactly what voltage the Zener effect takes place. So before we get and test that, what I would just want to highlight, and I'm going to annotate here, I do have an electronics tutorial on diodes. So if anything I'm talking about now is new to you, or you're not sure of how diodes or Zener diodes work, then I'm referring you to go and have a look at this tutorial, because it'll certainly help. What we obviously going to do when we're checking the Zener diode, we're not worried about its forward bias mode, we worried about its reverse bias mode, where the Zener effect happens, where there's a breakdown and then it allows a controlled current flow to act as potentially a voltage reference or a voltage regulator. So in the case when we do our testing, we are going to be connecting the positive to the cathode and the negative to the anode. And obviously note you've got the stripe there, and if we look carefully on some of these Zener diodes, it's fairly straightforward to see. You can see the stripe on the Zener diode designating which way the current should be flowing through it, and obviously it would be reversed biased that way. So that is how we're going to connect it up and check it. So let me just switch on the power supply and I'll show you a couple of methods. Right, so let's go through the first scenario where I've got a Zener diode, it's fallen out of a bag, I don't know what the value is, and I want to try and establish what it is. So I'm going to first use this Isotec power supply. Now, though this one is noted as Isotec, if you might have another one which looks exactly the same and it's under a different brand. The kind of most important item on a variable power supply which is going to help us determine the Zener value is the constant current light, or the current limit light. So that is one feature you want on your power supply, and it's hence why I'm going to show this across a couple of other supplies which don't look or operate exactly the same as this one, but this one certainly is the most straightforward. So to start off, what we want to do, I've got a set of test leads connected. I do have a handy set of grabbers for connecting the Zener diode. You may have a set of crocodile clips, but I'd certainly say you want something to connect it securely. You don't want to be sitting with a set of probes. So I'm going to switch on my power supply. The most important thing to do is to take all your adjustments down to zero. So normally that should obviously be down to the left. I've got my current fine, current coarse, my voltage fine, my current coarse, all turned straight down. I'm going to short the connectors together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to literally just take the fine adjustment of the current up, so that I've obviously got some current flow, and as you can see, it's flicked over to constant voltage. So once I've got that, and I've noted I've got just a low current, so I don't want a high current flowing, I flicked up the voltage, and what I'm adjusting for is a current of about 10 milliamp. And this is important because when you're testing, if you have a high current flowing through your Zener diode, you're going to damage it. So you only want, I'd say, 10-15 milliamp at most. Once you've got that current adjustment right, you're then ready to obviously play around with your voltage. So we take the voltage down. I then get the Zener diode, and as noted, so this side is the cathode, and that's the side which I'm going to, that's the side with a stripe. That is the side I'm going to connect the positive lead to. And then on the anode, I'm collecting the negative lead because we're obviously going to reverse bias it. Now, this is the point when I'm going to go to the course adjustment. And what I'm looking, as I adjust the voltage up, I'm looking for the point when the constant, it goes from a constant voltage mode and flicks across to a constant current. Because that's when the Zener effect has basically kicked in. So I'll turn up. There we go. And you can see it's flicked across. So at the moment, I'm on the course adjustment, and I can get it to the point just where it's adjusting. So what one might want to do is take the fine to the middle, and let's go find it flicking across again. There we go. And then if you really want to get the exact, you can use your fine to see where it flicks across to the constant current. And there we go. That at that voltage, that'll be your Zener voltage when it starts pushing back on the Zener diode itself. So there we go, that was quick and straightforward. I'm now going to get another one just as an example. Right, so again, I've got another scenario. I've got a packet here and the writing has been a bit smudged off, so I'm not 100% sure what the actual Zener value of this is. It might be a case that I know these are all 3 volts, but they might have a slightly different voltage at which they work at. So let's check that again. So again, I'm getting the positive clip onto the stripe side lead, the negative there. Now you can actually see it's already flicked over to constant current because I did go and adjust it down, but we're going to take it back down to 0. So here we go, we're at constant voltage mode. I'm going to swing up. There we go, it's just flicked across and it's at 3.2. Right, so let's use the fine adjustment. I'm going to come back. So there it's not conducting. Bang, there we go, the Zener effects. That's around 3.2 volts. So as you can certainly go and grade and find out exactly what the Zener effect is by using this method. And there's just a small current, obviously, of 10 milliamp flowing in this. So it certainly shouldn't damage it. But that's something to be wary of. Just be very wary of the amount of current that you allow during this test. Right, so I'm going to then now potentially show you 2 other scenarios that you might come across if you have Zener diodes which are damaged or faulty. So again, as I stated, we're going to connect up the positive clip to the stripe side lead and the negative to the other. I've got my controls right down. I've still got the current set to that 10 milliamp, and now I'm going to go up on the voltage side. And bang, can you see what's happened? It's flicked across to the constant current straight away with virtually no voltage. So what does that tell us? I must have a faulty Zener diode here, which is actually in a shorted state, so it's not going to function, but it's kind of blown closed, if you like, and that Zener is obviously faulty. Let's look at the next scenario. Right, we have our next one connected. I've got the voltage settings right down. I'm positive again, stripe side, which is the cathode, then the negative is on the anode, and now I'm going to adjust the voltage up. The little clicks are the relay in the power supply. I'm going all the way up, and what do you note? This is either a Zener diode with a very big, large value, or it's actually blown open, so it no longer operates. So those are 2 scenarios. If it starts conducting straight away, then it's probably shorted and faulty, and in this one, it's obviously blown open, so it's not operating. Right, and then what I thought I'd do was get this nice big fella out. It's rated as 12 volts, 5 watts, so it's a nice hefty Zener. And as you can see, it's got the coloring and the look of a silicon diode. So again, what I'm going to do, we've got the stripe. If I have a look and we bring into focus, you can see we've got the stripe on my on the right hand side here. So that's where I'm going to connect my positive. Going to connect the negative on the other side. The controls are down, still set to 10 milliamp, and now I'm going to dial up. Remember, it should be 12 volts. There we go. We've seen the light flick across from the constant voltage to the constant current. And if again, if we really wanted to get pernickety, and we could set the fine to the middle, bring it back to a point where it's changing, and then there we go. Just as it swings over, 11.4 volts. So even though this is rated for 12, as we can see through this test, we've established that it's actually going to start doing the Zener effect at 11.4 volts. Right, so here I want to demonstrate on a different type of power supply. This is a power supply that I built when I was in college, and it doesn't have a constant voltage light at all. It does have a constant current or a current limit light that comes on, and it's only got a simple analog display for the current. So what you carefully need to do if you are in the situation is you need to make sure that you haven't got a current that's too high. So I'm adjusting the voltage up, and I can carefully see there that I've got a few milliamp and my constant current light is coming on. So then I'm going to connect up the Zener diode again, before the positive to the stripe on the front, negatives on the back lead, and now I'm going to dial up the voltage, and what we're looking at is that constant current light. Bang. So there we go, you can see the lights come on. So we're going to go back to find the sweet spot. As I adjust, I don't have a fine adjust on this old college power supply, but it's showing, this one's showing around the 4.8. But I say on this power supply, I don't have that nice fine adjustment, but it's still, that's the method to use it to see when that constant current or constant limit comes on. Right, so now we're on to my TTI power supply, which is kind of the most expensive power supply I have, because the nice thing is you can go and preset your values before you actually enable the output. So on this one, I'm going to preset, so I don't have to play around with shorting the leads. Here we go, I'm going to set the current to 10 milliamp. You can see the voltage is set far too high, so I'm setting that down. I might just set my fine adjustment to the middle. And again, I've got the Zener diode connected up. So now I'm going to switch on the output. I don't have a, as I said, I don't have a constant voltage light on this. I just have a constant current light. So as we turn up, you can see up here, my constant current light has come on. So I'm going to use my fine adjustment to see if I can find the sweet spot. Don't have enough adjustment there. Let me just come back down. There we go. Okay, it's about 4.5, which is the same as the other power supply was, roughly the same as the other power supply was showing us. So there you go.
Right, so I hope you found that useful. As I said, the most important thing to note during that whole exercise to make sure you just limit the current that you've got on your variable power supply, because if you have it at a higher current and the Zener effect kicks in, you're obviously going to potentially damage the actual diode that you're testing. So do keep an eye on the comments below, because I'm sure there'll be some good pearls of wisdom noted below as well. Some other people might have some other methods, perhaps better methods for testing a Zener diode. But anyway, I thank you again for watching the video, and I'll catch you for the next one soon. Cheers.
Tester.co.uk